Hi everyone, thank you very much for joining us this evening on the Cornwall College Your Education Options in September live event. It's fantastic to have you with us, whether you're watching this live with us now or whether you see it on one of our repeats as well. The whole idea about this next hour that we're going to be sort of chatting and running through things is just to explain to everyone around Cornwall and Devon what your education options are in September. Whether you're just about to get your GCSE results, biting your nails time, I know, but good luck tomorrow. Whether you've had your A-level results and you're thinking about university, whether you're thinking about returning to education, whether you're an adult and you're just looking for something to do or looking for, we will cover that in the next hour, which is a lot to cover, I know. But first and foremost, let me introduce who's on the screen with me at the moment right now. So in the top right, we have Rory Mason, who's our VP Quality of Education. Hi, Rory.
Hi, Jamie. Good evening.
Good evening. We've got Connor Kendrew, who's our Curriculum Development Manager, very much involved in HE and former alumni. Hello, Connor.
Evening, Jamie. Evening, everyone. Good to be here.
And we've got Debs Williams as well, who's our head of counselling. And we're thrilled to have her with us as well this evening. Hi, Debs.
Hello.
Okay, so what we're going to do is I've done the introductions of who's onto the call, but what we've asked for is we've asked for people those of you who've signed up for this event and those of you who are dropping in, please ask any questions you've got into one of the chat functions that you've got, whether you're watching it on YouTube, one of our Facebook streams as well. And let me just sort of clarify as well, the Cornwall College group, you may just think Cornwall College. It's not just Cornwall College. It's Cornwall College in St Austell and Camborne and Newquay. But it's also Falmouth Marine School. It's Duchy College Rosewarne. It's Duchy College Stoke Climsland. We've got Bicton College in Devon. We've got St Mellin Golf Resort. We've got Cisner in Plymouth. There's so much going on across this group. And if you did manage to catch the opening video that we showed you, that's just a tiny element. And let me not forget Eden Project as well, Eden Project Learning, the fantastic HE courses we deliver there as well. Let's talk very quickly about the group as a whole. The group as a whole is on an incredible journey. Thanks to the learners, the staff, the parents, the schools, the businesses that support. We've had so much fantastic news over the last couple of years, and there's just so much more coming, and it's just brilliant, and it's an exciting time to be a part of this organisation, whether you're a member of staff, but particularly as a student, because the quality is there and the options are there, and there's just so many exciting things, and we're going to touch upon some of that as we go throughout the evening. But the hot topic for tomorrow, and there's going to be so many of you out there this evening, and I feel very sorry for you, in the fact that you're probably very nervous, but I also feel very jealous of you because you're a lot younger than I am, and it means you've got a lot of exciting opportunities ahead of you. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to speak to, first of all, Rory. Rory, can you just give a real quick, and this is not easy to do, but overview of what the options are for those people who are getting their GCSE results tomorrow and may not be sure exactly what they want to do when they get those results.
Yeah, absolutely, Jamie. First thing to say is good luck tomorrow for all of you receiving your results. You know, what a journey you've been on over the last couple of years. You're probably the only generation in recent history to have learned through a pandemic. You know, you've experienced remote learning, you've experienced blended learning, you've been back in the classroom, but you're the first students who would have sat an exam in 2 years. So you've made a little bit of history with that, and it's probably felt a little bit tougher for everyone. So congratulations on getting through that. And good luck for tomorrow. You are going to be nervous tonight, you know, no doubt. But actually, you should be excited because tomorrow morning when you wake up, regardless of your results, your next step in education will be something that you've chosen to do, not something you're made to do. And learning will feel so different when you get up in the morning to study a subject you're passionate about. So you might have got better results than you expected, and that might shift and change what you want to do next. You might not have got the results you wanted, and that might be a sideways step to get to where you want to go in the long run. But absolutely, at the Cornwall College Group, we'll have something for you to make sure that we get you to the career of your dreams. We're talking about careers, not jobs. Jobs are something you do to go and get money. Careers are something you do that you love, and we're all about getting you to the career of your dreams. So there's never been more choices, you know, and as Jamie said, you know, he joked about age, but what a time to be able to come into education. You can study a study programme, which is a full-time vocational, hands-on practical way to learn. You're generally going to be in the classroom for most of the week, but you'll work with industry experienced teachers. You'll go out on work experience placements. You'll have industry trips, industry visits, and you'll be equipped with the skills you need to either progress on to university or directly into the workplace. You can do an apprenticeship. You've probably heard this sort of the slogan, earn while you learn, generally saying you work, go to come to college one day a week, and you learn in our practical workshops and teaching spaces, and then you're in the workplace for the other 4 days a week, and you're paid to come and learn. I'll just say that again, you're paid to come and learn, you know, and what a way to study. So we've got the apprenticeship route as well. Next year, we'll be offering T-level. So that's not for this year, but next year we're offering T-level. So that will be yet another option for you. So lots and lots of really exciting ways to learn, but our focus is professional and technical, practical, hands-on learning. If you've already applied to study with us, you're going to get a phone call tomorrow or on Friday, and that'll be from one of the teaching team in the area that you've applied to study, and they will talk you through those next steps. If you've got the grades you need to progress, it'll be a really simple, quick phone call. It'll be getting you ready for the start of term, answer any questions you've got, really smooth process. If you didn't get the results you expected, higher or lower, one of our teaching team will talk you through all the options in front of you. Absolutely, it is nothing to worry about. We will have an answer for you. And as I said, it might be a sideways step, or it might be that you're progressing to the next level of the course a little bit faster than you expected. But either way, we'll be here to support. If you haven't applied to the Cornwall College group, don't worry. Just get on the website. You can either click the apply button and you can apply online. And one of our customer service team will phone you up and we'll go through like what we refer to as like a first stage interview, but find out a little bit about more about you, make sure that the course that you think you want to apply for is suitable, and then they'll get you in touch with the teaching team. Or you can phone up and ask to speak directly to the campus or teaching team and we can answer your questions there. The key thing is, don't panic, don't worry. There's a whole army of people here to support you from tomorrow onwards, and try and be excited about it. This is your next step in education. And as I said at the start, studying something you love is very, very different to studying something you don't.
Yeah, thanks for that overview, Rory. I mean, I think what I'll do is I'll try and share my screen without crashing the whole system here. If we can get that into the screen. Yeah, there we go. Fantastic. So what I'm on here is I'm on our cornwall.ac.uk homepage. So all you need to do is, we've got a banner up at the top here, and GCSE results day. So, and this is going to be some more information and resources for you that Rory was touching upon there. So some of your questions answered. I've got my results. How do I enroll? I didn't get my selected results. How can you help? I don't know what to do or want to change my course. You can see that a lot of these options involve calling our number. Don't do that this evening. They've gone home for their dinner. But first thing in the morning, give them a call. I'm a returning student as well, Fries. And you can request a call there as well. There's also some other things here, top tips and take some time out. So we've put together some resources here. If you are feeling a little stressed, there's a parent's guide up there as well. So if you're a parent watching this, or you know, please click on that, download it. There's lots of useful information how you can help. We've even got some playlists. We've got some tracks here we've pulled together that will hopefully boost your mood. We've got some unwinding elements here. There's a few of our staff have made some great little videos of how to look after yourself. Breakfast tomorrow, we've sorted it for you. There you go, green smoothie, that's how you do it, or a berry bowl. And we've got some other useful info as well and links like that. So just to show that, you know, those go onto the website. We've got all that resource there for you, really useful information, and just little bits and ways you can help and unwind. And I think it's really important as well, we talked about that very generally as well, but I think the difference between what we do and that school experience is that thing of, we do so many courses that lead directly into careers where they may not have ever even considered that in school, whether that's working with wildlife, whether that's out in fields, whether it's all these different practical and skills. I mean, that's something that, I mean, Rory, if you could just give some of the examples of some of the things, I mean, whether it's horticulture, whatever it might be, they don't have to think, oh gosh, I've got to choose something where I'm sat in a classroom, start, you know, they're doing something incredibly academic.
Yeah, you know, absolutely, Jamie. I guess the key thing is it won't be a classroom-based experience. It will be so much more than that. You know, if you come to study games design, you'll be working with real clients on real life briefs where you might be designing a game for a local company. You might be working on a board game. We've just done a board game project where we teamed up with an international company and we were having to live chat and live stream to Australia and America to produce a board game. If you're learning about media production or film production, you could be in a television studio in the morning. You could be out shooting a film on location in the afternoon. If you come to us to study marine biology, well, look where we are in the country. We've got some of the most beautiful coastline this country has to offer. And you could be out on field exercises. You know, some of our HE students last year in their first week were out spotting dolphins. So where possible in every single course, we are always going to do practical hands-on or experience-based learning. So it's about equipping you with the skills that enable you to do the job and making it as fun as possible along the way. Challenging, because you should be stretched all of the time. You don't want to be bored. It should be a stretch learning something new, but it should be fun as well. So yeah, experience-led learning that is shaped by what the employment sector that you want to go into needs.
I mean, talking of the employment sector, it leads very nicely into this first question that's come through. Thank you very much for this one. I'm thinking of doing an apprenticeship. Do I need to find an employer first? Is there support available to help find one? This is a classic, isn't it? It's an absolute people understanding of apprenticeships and how it works. So, Roy, I'll just quickly throw that one back to you.
The options there? Really good question. So ideally, you should be working with an employer. If you're thinking you want to do an apprenticeship, lots of people have an employer they would like to work with in mind, but it's not essential. We have a team of people at the college to match you. So you might have an idea of the apprenticeship that you want to take on. It might be something in automotive, for example, and you might have a local garage that you'd like to go and work with, and you've already got that relationship, but you might not have. And we have a team, an apprenticeship team, who can help you link with an employer. We have at any one point between 60 and 100 vacancies for apprenticeships across the group. So there are lots and lots of opportunities out there for you. So again, if you've got an idea of the apprenticeship you want to do and you haven't got an employer lined up, speak to us, because we might have someone lined up ready for you. And it might be that the apprenticeship is not there straight away because we haven't got an employer there. But once we know what you want to do, we can support you with finding that employer. So you're not on your own with it. And again, we're here to help. But like I said, if you have got an employer you'd like to work with and you've started that conversation, that's also brilliant too.
Brilliant. We're talking about the 16 to 18 and GCSE results. Last week was A-level results. And we've got all those people who are now thinking, do I go to university? Am I doing the right course? Do I want to go away to study? I mean, Southwest is... The biggest region for people not traveling to go to university, whereas I think it's the West Midlands are the highest as well. So we know that about 50% of the people who come to do a degree with the Cornwall College Group are from out of county in terms of Cornwall. The other 50% are from within Cornwall. Now, Connor, I'm going to come to you here because you traveled from out of county, I know, to actually study a degree with us. You're now very much part of the heart of Cornwall College and its HE provision. We do HE provision across the group, but Newquay, Eden and Camborne in particular have probably the most. Can you just give a sense of your journey with HE and the Cornwall College group?
Yeah, without a doubt, Jamie. Yeah, so it's very true. I made the cross. I went over the Tamar Bridge and came to study my degree with Cornwall College. That was in 2015. So I can still just about remember it. I can also remember opening my paper envelope with my A-level results as well. And it's a strange time because you don't always know exactly what you want to end up doing. And I certainly didn't. I knew that I wanted to be engaged with the natural world. I knew that I wanted to work, you know, out and about, consulting, trying to make nature a better place for everyone. But funnily enough, I actually went to an employer and I asked that employer, what do I do? I wanted to do an apprenticeship. I wanted to do a degree apprenticeship with them. And they said, well, your A-level results are this. Have you heard of Cornwall College Newquay? They run excellent foundation degrees, which you would be able to get onto. I wasn't able to get onto a full BSc with the UCAS points I'd attained. So that was when I first realized one of the first really big points about HE within an FE framework. It's really flexible in terms of what you can apply for. We run HNC, HND, FDSC, you know, FDAs, all the way up to BSCs and BAs, and even some master's degrees now as well. And that means there's a little slice of HE that's available for everyone. We also have gateway years as well, if you don't feel that you're ready to go on to that first year of a degree as well. And so that really worked very, very well for me. I've got my unconditional offer with Cornwall College Newquay. I studied applied ecology, which is now zoology with conservation and ecology. It's been revamped since. And off I was, you know, immediately, first week, freshers week, we were out in the field doing pond surveys, doing reptile surveys, we're doing bird surveys. I was going up onto the moors of Cornwall. I was going out on boats trying to spot basking sharks, surveying tiny little zooplankton as well. So from the very, very big to the very, very small. And it wasn't all that. There was quite a lot of academic work as well, a lot of reading, a lot of learning how to reference properly, learning how to, you know, decipher the truth that's out there as well. And at the end of it, the employment opportunities, the connections I made, the friends I made that I still have today, it all formed who I am. So much so that I now work at the very institution I went to. So, yeah.
Thanks for that, Connor. We'll come back to you immediately after. But I just wonder, we've had a question come through from Michaela Robbins, and we're going back to apprenticeships here. So she says, my son has been trying to apply to various companies for the last 6 months to enable him to do a plumbing apprenticeship. No one is interested. Are you able to help him find a company in West Cornwall who'd be likely to take him on? Now, I'm going to throw this over to you, Rory, on this one. But I think it's applied to what you said, because we do have that team there, don't we? And I think the thing is, it's about finding the right opportunity for people with the situation they're in, and that's we're exactly the right people to be talking to.
Yeah, it can be really tough if you're looking at a specific area, but that's exactly why we have an apprenticeship team. So we will have a team, and as I said, there might not be the placement there right now, but we have roll-on dates throughout the academic year for new starts in apprenticeships. Absolutely, we'll be able to help you find a place. I'm just having a look. Is it for your son? Yeah, for your son in plumbing. Plumbing and electrical is really popular. Anyone who lives in Cornwall can see the need, the number of building that's taking place. It's monumental. You know, you've probably, some of the people on the call, some of the people, you know, in the virtual room now have found how hard it is to get a plumber. There's a massive need for plumbers.
I needed one last night. Literally.
So, yeah, we'll help you. It might not be an instant, okay, we've got an employer ready for tomorrow, but we will be able to support you. It might just take a few more weeks than you originally expected, but it's absolutely worth waiting for the right employer, for the right fit, and then we'll get you on that apprenticeship.
Yeah, so Michaela, if you could call the contact number or go onto the Cornwall College website or CCB, which is Cornwall College Business, any of those, if you look up Cornwall College Apprenticeships and how to contact, I'll ask our fantastic production team in the background to put up the number across the bottom here. I'm sure they'll get to that. But Michaela, thank you very much for your question. And I think the thing is, tomorrow, what we'll do is we'll start your son and you on that journey of finding you, a solution to what he wants to do and how he gets there. And as Rory said, if it isn't instant, it might be, you know, we might have had that conversation with that plumber who's looking for someone, and it can happen very quickly. If that's not the case, there's other options out there, and there's other things that can be doing, that can be working on in the meantime, that will make your son as a more attractive employee to that plumber. So by the time an opportunity does come up, they're very much he's at the forefront of the mind of when those opportunities come. But thank you very much for your question, and hopefully we'll be able to start that journey tomorrow. If we head back to HE quickly, because there's a lot to discuss within HE. Connor, cost of living, cost of university. Why should someone think, you know what, it's worth me taking on that debt to go to university?
I think the very quick, easy answer to that is higher skills. One of the things that you do at university is obviously you study a subject, but another thing you develop in the round is higher level skills, analytical skills, critical skills, the ability to go and really find out and research. And those softer skills that we develop during a degree will help you through the whole of the rest of your life, be that applying for jobs, be that entering social situations, you know, motivating yourself, for example. All of that is, in my mind, something that is invaluable and in addition to the subject that you'll be learning. You will see a complete transformation of yourself by studying a degree. On the same notion of the fact that we do have a pretty big cost of living issue at the moment, that we all have to be very sympathetic towards, the fees themselves, as someone who recently has taken out a student loan, obviously the fees themselves will not be felt right there, right then. And also, depending on your situation, depending on your financial grounding of where you're from, you have to also realize that there's not just loans available, but there are grants as well. We also have, within our own campuses, within our own courses, we have bursaries available for students. We have abilities to help people out financially as they go through their time with us as a student. So to answer that, they are tough times, but they are invaluable skills that you'll be developing. It's a plunge that millions of people are taking. Millions of people have degrees and have done degrees and have done so during uncertain times. So I would say a little bit of bravery and a little bit of you know, finding out the support that's available will allow you to achieve that degree still.
Jamie, I'm just going to jump in and just add to what Connor said. You know, a degree is an investment. It is an investment in yourself and an investment in your own abilities. You know, the most important thing for any young person, for any adult, is it's about the right course for the right individual. And that's what our course teams are here to advise on. We'll make sure that it's the right course at the right time for you in your life. So many people who go to study degrees will fall back on that degree later in their life. So many people who've gone into industry will then need a degree to potentially teach in the industry that they've come out of. So it will always be an investment, and you can all read the many statistics are out there about how it impacts your overall salary and earning potential in your lifetime. But it's not for everyone, and that's why we've got alternative offers like apprenticeships.
And I think that's really, it's that point, isn't it? That if you want to progress, if you want to look at education, if you want to change things up, if you want to just try something, there's so much available. And I think that's what most people don't realize. There is literally so many levels of courses, from a one day taster doing Italian cookery just to, you know, help us that, all the way up to doing a master's, as we said, and every single thing in between. And I think that's what I will do, actually, is there was a comment made from one of our colleagues, and it's lovely to have our colleagues watching this as well, Sally Roberts, who says, please, can you recommend access to HE courses where potential students need an academic level 3 qualification? Now, I'm a huge fan of access courses. I think they're incredible. And these are just the perfect courses for someone who thinks, you know what, I'm really interested in getting into higher education again. School maybe didn't happen the way, you know, how I, you know, it wasn't for me at the time, getting the results that needed to get onto that course. These access courses are incredible. In a short space of time, you can find yourself. We have people who are literally, I didn't get any A-level results, I didn't get anything like that. They managed to find themselves onto an access course, and before they know it, they're in university doing nursing and such things. I mean, Connor, can you just talk a little bit about that access route to explain it a bit more for people?
Oh, without a doubt. Yeah. So that access year will, depending on where you are in your life journey, let alone your educational journey, will give you those foundation skills to allow you to go in and take up that journey on a higher education. So, yeah, the access to science courses that we run develop that analytical report writing, going and finding out kind of attitude that scientists need. My mum, for example, is never had a degree, you know, finished school and went straight into the world of work. at the age of 52, decided that she wanted to be a childhood nurse. She did an access course with her local college, and now she's a graduate doing a micro master's with the NHS. So this kind of formula really can work wonders for you. And it, no matter where you are, who you are, you can pick up an access course and really start to make that change. The same goes for our gateway year that we have at Cornwall College Newquay as well. It's very much the same thing.
Yeah, absolutely. And it's worth noting as well that any fees around the access course, I mean, it's always worth checking the details on all this, but your fees for an access course, if you can then go on to complete a degree, are actually waived. So, I mean, it really is. It's a fantastic opportunity. So thanks for the reminder to remind people, Sally. It's an incredibly important point. Tyler Worth asks, and it's a similar lines of what we're talking about, those who may not have studied for years or are out of education, haven't studied for years but would like to become a teacher. Where do I start this journey? I mean, does anyone want to jump onto that one? Rory, that's going to be you.
Yeah, okay. There's so many different ways to do it now. You can come in now through the apprenticeship route to study as a teacher. And we've had people come in for the early years route, for people come in and become PE teachers, starting with access and then going on to an apprenticeship. But likewise, we run what we refer to as ACL, or adult community learning courses. So they're like bite-sized taster courses, and you can pretty much do an ACL course in any subject you imagine. So you might start off doing one, for example, in catering. You might come do some basic bread or a basic Italian 2 hours a week for 3 weeks. And you think, do you know what? I really enjoyed that. I could see myself teaching that. What you can do then is you can roll on what we call an AET course, which is an order in education and training. And we run them in lots of different ways. You can do sometimes one over a 10-week period. Sometimes we run them more condensed over a 5-week period. And after you complete the AET, you can go on to the DET, the Diploma in Education and Training. And what we actually offer, because we're such a big group with so much resource and so much provision, is actually we can get you into some of those teaching placements within the group and actually delivering some of the courses that you went on to first study to get your first taste of what it might like to become a teacher. So lots of different routes to get into becoming a teacher. And if you think it's just the old-fashioned route of just, you know, going to college, studying a vocational qualification like an extended diploma or doing your A-level and then going to university, then doing a teaching qualification, it's absolutely not. There's so many flexible ways to do it now. We train lots and lots of teachers every year across the Cornwall College group, particularly from industry. So, you know, we talked a little bit about plumbing, for example, 10 minutes ago. Lots and lots of people who work in the plumbing trade then, you know, decide that they want to impart those skills with the next generation, or indeed with people who want a career change. So we work with plumbers and electricians and engineers, and they come to us and they learn how to be a teacher, and then they go on and train the next plumbers, the next electricians, the engineers of the future. And that's something we've got a long history of at the Cornwall College Group, and a really successful way of, and really passionate about, because we're passionate about learning, we're passionate about teaching. And it's something that we really enjoy doing. So again, call the number on the website and we'll get someone in touch. We've got a whole team of people who can advise you on that.
Well, I mean, it's very timely as well, because we had the chief executive of the group today, who's sort of renowned nationally for his teaching of teachers and how to improve. We had 30 new teachers in the room learning those skills, learning exactly that, becoming improving on their teaching. So that having that knowledge base and that skill set down here to bring people really to the top of the game, it's a great time to be
to jump in there. That, you know, our CEO John Evans comes from an automotive background, and he studied an apprenticeship, and he's now head of one of the biggest colleges in the country. You know, so it really shows that there are so many ways into teaching, and that's, you know, that's where his career started, with an apprenticeship, and now he leads one of the biggest teaching institutions in the UK.
Within education, we know it, there's a ton of acronyms, and we have a question here. I'm a little confused about HNC, FDSC, FDA, etc. Are these degrees? So I think we can say that, can't we, that education is full of all these words. It can get very confusing for people. And I don't know whether you'd agree with me. I'd like your views on this. But I'd say that if at all there's any inkling in the back of your mind, no matter what age you are, no matter what stage of your life you are, and you just think, I want to do something different, I want a change, don't worry about all the levels. Don't worry about all the what is and what is. If you get in touch, we can have that discussion with you, can't we? And I mean, and that's it, isn't it? Because everyone's journey is slightly different. Everyone's going to be entering at a different level, wanting to do a different thing. I mean, what's your advice to people? Debs, can you sort of...
Yeah, absolutely. I tend to get a lot of adult learners on my courses, and they're concerned about whether their qualifications might be too old or they don't have sufficient HE credits. And we actually look at the whole person, because very often somebody's had some really fantastic training in placements and industry, and that forms part of our assessment. So it's really worth talking to a program manager or one of the tutors and spending some time really kind of unpicking what you want, what you have, and what we can achieve for you. So, yeah, always ask that question.
And I think we see it every day overlooking the group. I mean, I see, you know, whether you look at Falmouth Marine School, Marine Engineering, you know, they're getting some very exciting stuff coming around, renewables and things like that, with incredible stuff happening at Newquay, at Eden, across all these different things, at Rosewarne. And I'm just thinking that there's so many people who may not be right now, they may be sat there thinking, what am I doing with my life? Do you know what I mean? They might be stuck in a rut. They might be doing it. And it's just knowing that they are a phone call away, an email away from absolutely fundamentally changing their life for the better.
Absolutely.
It's incredible, isn't it? And it's I think that's one of the biggest frustrations that you have is, you know, you've got, and you see it, because we'll be in November, we'll all be in the cathedral in Truro with people graduating, changing their lives. I mean, the stories, you know, I, from the marketing side, I speak to these people and they are literally there with their friends and family having one of the best days of their life, and their lives have just been transformed. They're just, you know, doing all sorts of kind of things. And it's not just HE, it's whether they're we've got so many incredible alumni. And I think that's the thing to get across, isn't it? It's if you're thinking about it at all, there's no harm in making a phone call. There's no harm in sending an email. Find out. It's literally taking that first step. And once you've taken that first step, the amount of support. I mean, can you just also just, you know, talk about some of the support within this group for people getting through the things is incredible, absolutely incredible.
Yeah.
We're all jumping in because there's so much there. Yeah. It's a very important part of this college's philosophy. It's actually at the foundation of this group's belief, which is to put the student first and to support them.
Absolutely. I mean, I think Rory's got the values up behind him, but I don't think it's in yellow. It's just out short, but learner first is our first. But Connor, you were going to say as well the...
Yeah, some people might paint an image of a degree of going and sitting in a 400-strong lecture theatre and maybe falling asleep at the back and having a professor that doesn't even know your name. This is an assumption, but that is the stark opposite of the situation that we have here. Our cohorts are on average quite a bit smaller. And our teaching staff will walk past you in the corridor and they will know your name and they will check in on you and they will know what your last assignment was and how you've been getting on with that and where you need to go and where you are going in your interests as well. So to go with that flexibility that I was talking about when I chucked out all those acronyms, which, by the way, are just pieced up years of a degree. A degree doesn't have to be I'm signing up for 3 or 4 years. You can throw your hat in the air every single year if you need to. They think that flexibility and that personability will allow you to take the career and the educational pathway that is right for you. I see that working here as not necessarily a teaching member of staff. I sort of am a fly on the wall watching that amazing back and forth relationship between learner and teacher all the time.
I guess, you know, the key thing to add into this is we succeed if you succeed. you know, it is in our interest to support you from day one. You know, the minute you touch base with the Cornwall College Group and make your application, that's when we start learning about you and the best way to support you. And we just generate a really strong relationship of trust where there are no silly questions, where we will bend over backwards to put the support in place to make sure you learn in the most effective way for you, because everybody's got different ways they like to learn. And we work really hard to support that. It's really important to say that. And I think Zara, who asked one of the questions, said, look, there's a lot of acronyms. Talk to me about all these different qualifications. Well, we could spend all night doing that. But essentially, I mean, Connor's probably the best position to do this, but you can really put HE into FDAs and FDSCs, BAs and BSCs, and HNCs, HNDs. Connor, do you want to say a little bit about each one of those?
Yeah, so let's start with the HNC, the Higher National Certificate, which is the very first year of a degree. It can stand alone. You come in, you do your HNC. It's really an enjoyed kind of course by sectors such as horticulture. HNCs, we offer an HNC in horticulture. They're very popular because a lot of employers like to see someone who's just got that HNC and they're ready for work. Likewise, however, that HNC, that very first year of a degree, equivalent to the first year of, let's say, a three-year degree, can progress you on to an FDSC or an FDA. So that's a foundation, which is 2 years of a degree in either science, the SC, or art, the A. Okay, so again, it's not a lesser course, it's just a shorter course. It's not a three-year or a bachelor's, it's a two-year degree. I did an FDSC, and you graduate, you get your certificate, you get a grade, and that can take you into the world of work. Or if you have an institution like ourselves that offer a one-year BSc or BA top-up, you can then go from that FDSC, that FDA, into the bachelor's. Now, a bachelor's with honours is the third year of a degree. It's at level 6. Okay, so you know it's a high level course. It's the degree that most people sign up for is the bachelor's, and the honours bit is that you do a little bit of independent research, a little bit of an independent research project and study. Okay, so there it is. It's just building blocks. And, you know, if you think that, you know, there's 3 blocks or 3 years that makes up a BSc or a BA, we've taken those apart and made them more flexible for you.
Absolutely. And that flexibility is key, isn't it? Because everyone's life is different. Some people have families and things they need to look up, their commitments, they've got to work, all these sorts of things. The most important thing is there's almost always a solution. Almost. I'm going to go quickly back to Michaela Robbins, who was talking to us earlier about her son looking for that promise. She asked if it's unlikely an apprenticeship will be found before September, but I would recommend obviously getting in contact with our apprenticeship team. Would it be worth starting the plumbing studies diploma to gain skills for next year? Now, Michaela, I'll say again that get in contact with the apprenticeship team tomorrow, run through the options and things like that. But Rory, would you mind just picking up on this? Because I think you can address it directly, but then there's a wider point to be made, I think.
Yeah, it's a really, really good question. The first thing to say is yes, absolutely. I have to say a lot of learners who are coming straight from school will come on and do either a 1 year level one or a two-year program, do a level one and then a level two, depending on the knowledge, skills, experience they come in with. You know, if you want to progress on and become a plumber and have a career in plumbing, but you're coming straight from school, there's a lot to learn. You know, there's a lot of science to it as well. And actually, a lot of employers will say, do you know what? We'd love to work with you, but you're not quite ready. What we'd like you to do is go to college for a year or for 2 years and build up those foundation, those underpinning skills before you come and work with us. And it's a great way to do it because you get the college experience then. You get to meet lots of like-minded people in the same sort of trade and career that you want to progress onto. And once you're in at college studying plumbing at level one or level two, you're doing work experience and you're meeting employers from day dot. So you're in the perfect position. So when we do get employers come to us to say, look, we've got an apprenticeship vacancy coming up, you're first in the queue. And we have lots of people who might come on to do a level one plumbing course. They complete their level one, they start their level two. And at the start of their level two, an employer comes to us and say, we need 3 people for this business and we transfer you across. And that's a successful destination. So you're even in a better position, you know, if you go on and study a full-time program in that area. And, you know, to be completely transparent and honest, most employers in plumbing and electrical would want you to do at least a level one first, if not a level two. Some students can start with a level two, depending on their GCSE grades. Some students will need to do the level one first and then progress on to the level two. But that is the preferred route in those two trades. So I'd say absolutely come in, have an interview with one of the team in plumbing. It's a really big team. The workshops are incredible. You know, we've got mock kitchens, mock bathrooms. If you can imagine it, we've got it. And, you know, we recycle all of our copper. It's such a big, exciting department. In our Brunel building, we can build a two-story house, plumb it, wire it, take it all down and go again. So come in, meet the team, look at the facilities, see what we've got. And as I said, that position you perfectly when that opportunity comes up, if you can't find an apprenticeship from the outset.
Yeah, thank you for that, Michaela. Much appreciated. There's a question that's come through for Anna, and it says, what support is available for pupils who have developed anxiety during the pandemic? Moving school and friendship group is a lot of change, even for those without mental health issues. It's such a pertinent question. What we found was, I know we were one of the first organisations to actually have real live events post-pandemic, or at that point when we were allowed to. And I remember speaking to some of the parents there, and they were just saying, it's amazing to see a college from, school. It's a transition, it's a difference. It certainly is, isn't it? And like they say, even without any mental health issues. You've seen the impact of this, all of you, we all have, of mental health. What would you say to someone who's thinking, oh, I kind of maybe want to leave the school environment and go on to college, but I'm feeling really nervous about it? What would you say to them?
I think one of the things that really strikes me about Cornwall College is that the staff work in a very joined up way. So it's a really holistic approach to working with students. So, I mean, even today, I was working with quite a diverse group of staff, all trying to support a learner. So, we have student experience officers, we have safeguarding, we have personal tutors, we have careers advice, we have a mental health service that comes in to support students. Obviously, I'm kind of situated in counselling, and I've got a fantastic kind of group of trainee counsellors that we draw on to actually help support our students. So we provide guidance for well-being, we provide workshops on exam stress, we talk about bullying, we talk about, managing anxiety, panic attacks, we can, teach young people some very practical skills. And the wealth of practical exercises now on the website, on the college website, is just incredible. I mean, that's a massive change. It's about finding a connection with the right person, building trust, and there's enough people that pupils will come in contact with to make sure that the right person will be there for them.
Absolutely. Thank you, Deb. And I think we're obviously talking about, our students coming onto. We'll talk about our adult offer in a minute. But I think what's often forgotten within this equation is the parents, the carers, the teachers, and their understanding of what a further education college actually is and what it does. We don't actually do A-levels. And for a lot of teachers, a lot of parents, that's what they know. That it's like, you do your A-levels, you go to a university. They may not have experienced that college environment. What would you say to the parents, Rory, of those someone who's a student has seen us in school, maybe they've come to one of our careers fest days, and they've gone, this bit was amazing. I want to do esports. And the parents going, one, what? And two, where? what are you saying to them?
Well, the first thing I'd say is they've made a really good choice if they've chosen the group. Look, as I said, our job is to ensure learners succeed and go on to the career of their dreams. absolutely people will feel nervous about coming from a school environment. If you come to study with us on a study program or an apprenticeship, you know, you might start at entry level, you might go to level one, you might go to level two. You know, a level two is genuinely the equivalent of four GCSEs. And then you'll progress on to a level three, which could be an extended diploma. An extended diploma counts for just a little bit more than three A levels. Over one in four people who go on to university studied an extended diploma to get there. So it's a really successful route. And actually, if you specialise in a subject with an extended diploma, you've got a massive head start when you go on to that degree, because you've already like honed in and started to focus on something, and you'll have industry skills, software skills, workshop-based skills, field-based skills. But people who have done the A-level route, where they've done three separate things, they'll have a fraction of that. So you'll have a massive head start. When you come to college, like, our job is to make you feel safe. You know, it's to make you feel supported, to make you feel secure. We have an induction period in every course where we get to know you and you get to know us, and we create a really nice environment where you get to meet new people, like-minded people, you know, and that's really exciting. You know, that's the fabric of life. And we specialize in that for the first 2 weeks of every program and beyond. And, you know, sometimes you might feel anxious, but sometimes that might be nervousness and excitement. And there's a crossover of those two things. And just stepping through the door can be that first bit. So we will look after you in those first few weeks and make sure that you feel comfortable. And, you know, because we want to create a learning environment where you can ask any question, you can ask for any support, and you really enjoy being in that. When it comes to things like assignments, you know, if you're worried about, you know, report writing, or if you're worried about a practical exercise, again, talk to us, tell us, and we'll help you with that. You might be nervous about doing a presentation, but we're not going to make you do a presentation in front of a huge group. We'll build you up slowly. In fact, you might start doing a presentation on a bit of VR software. You know, we can virtually create a group. There's all sorts of different ways to do it. It's very much about getting to know you. And the person that's going to get to know you best is your study program manager, also known as your personal tutor. And they will get to know what motivates you, where you want to go, what things you're worried about, what things you get excited about. That'll be the person you know best across the year, 2 years, or even 3 years of your course. And their job is to get you through that course and get you out with the highest grade possible. You know, and I spent a long time as a study program manager in this area. I live and work in the Campbell Paul Lug and Redruth area, and I see students I taught 15 years ago now, and we talk about what they've gone on to do and the successes they've had, and I remember each and every one of them and their journey, because I got to know them so well over that time I spent with them. And we love it, we pride ourselves on it, we're really excited. There's nothing better than working with enthused people who want to change their lives, and that's what we're all about.
Brilliant, thanks Rory. We've got 10 minutes left. Debs, I'm going to come to you now, and because I want to talk about our adult offer. Obviously, adults go to university and they can do access, and they even do apprenticeships and things like that. And let's not forget as well, and it's really worth remembering this, we adults can come on to what are traditionally perceived as those college level, those 16 to 18 courses. They're not capped at 18. There's funding and things like that, but if you really want to get into you know, if you wanted to get into esports and you found your way in, and you're 20 odd or whatever, however old, you can look into doing that. There's options for people, so I would say that. But Debs, our adult offer, I mean, we've got hundreds and hundreds of courses across this group, ranging from, and we'll do it again, Italian cooking, all the way up to I want to be an accountant and I only want to study online. Can you just give an overview of the incredible opportunities on the adult?
Yeah, absolutely. Kind of the difference for me, kind of with working with adult students, is because very often people have been out of education for some time, there's a lot of kind of confidence issues. So it could be that you might want to start by just kind of start gently with a short course, maybe related to a hobby or something that you're really interested in, which doesn't necessarily have, you know, assessments and, you know, that kind of academic side. Come along to a taster session, with counselling, you can come along to St. Austell or Camborne and spend a day with somebody who is now a qualified counsellor, who's gone through their training with us, and just ask any kind of questions, just get a flavour. It could be that you're somebody who has always secretly wanted to do something, but life just kind of took a different turn. And it might be a chance, maybe the children have left home, maybe you've got more time on your hands, that you want to think about taking the first steps into maybe a new career. It's genuinely never too late. I mean, certainly in my field, I want people with life experience, yeah? I want people who have tasted the highs and lows, yeah? So, anything from studying a short course to get your confidence up, maybe a hobby, all the way through to starting a brand new career, it's never too late.
No, absolutely. Thanks, Dad. And I think that brings very nicely to the fact that we call ourselves the Career College. I think you can see it on the banner behind me, actually, the hashtag, the Career College. And I think when we do talk about points of difference in various options of where people can go, that extreme focus between the value of learner first combined with being the Career College, almost every single course we do here, there's an intent and an aim for it to be able to be used on your journey to a new career or the career you want or switching up. And that really is a point of difference, isn't it? I mean, I know it's written within all the courses that we do.
Jamie, can I just come in there? Because one thing I didn't kind of mention, which is actually important when I think about people that I work with, we often have a lot of people who are actually working in professions, but who want to kind of upskill, who want to kind of focus on an area where perhaps there isn't the training available. So I think it's worth saying that, you know, yes, there's courses, you know, short courses, hobbies, and yes, you can make a massive big career change, but there's a lot in between as well. So I tend to get a lot of nurses, a lot of healthcare workers, a lot of care assistants who want to learn quite specific kind of communication and counselling skills, for example. You know, the same applies in different areas. But, you know, you can come in to do a specific piece of learning that's going to enhance and benefit what you're actually doing at the moment.
Absolutely. And another example of that, I guess, to put it within the construction world, we get plenty of people. They might be a brickie, they might be, you know, trade, and they're like, actually, you know what? I'm going to come do the plastering course of this, because then that's another string to my bow, and then build and build and build. And before you know it, the suite of skills that they've got is quite incredible.
Jamie, I think that is such a strong example. You know, and we have a Saturday skills program at the college, which is just specifically geared for exactly, you might have someone who wants to do a bit of plastering, wants to learn a bit more about painting and decorating, wants to have an introduction to plumbing. It might be something that's brand new to them, or as you said, it might be a plumber who wants to have that plastering string to their bow as well. But likewise, you know, I'm just thinking about learners I've spoken to over the last few months, you know, before the summer. I've got someone from a health and social care background training to be a mechanic. You know, I've got a manager of a national supermarket chain training to be a nurse, because after the pandemic, they wanted to do a job that really made a difference. I've also got a mechanic now training to be a photographer. We've got a whole army of people training to be HGV drivers, you know, fully funded by the government. You know, if you think there's something you might want to change and do, we will have a way for you to do that. But likewise, you know, as a college, we are proud to be at the heart of our community. So you can come and do a hobby course, a leisure course. If you think, do you know what, I just want to try something and see what it's like. You know, I don't want to do a qualification. I just want to do a taster. We've got those as well. So do it with a friend. You know, a couple of you come. They're all free if you're over 18. And you can come and have a go at one of those adult tasters. And you'll find out there's also so many different ways to learn. So, for example, in accountancy right now, you can do an accountancy course with us, an AAT, which is the industry standard recognized course. You can do it online, or you can do it blended, which is where the teacher is online, but also physically in the classroom. So because of your life, you might have children, you might have job responsibilities, and you want to do it from home, and you want to join in via Teams or Skype or whatever the platform might be. But you go, some weeks think, do you know what? I need to see that person face to face. They will be in the classroom delivering that session. So you've got that blended approach. So there's, you know, one of the pluses out of the pandemic fantastic, is it opened up a whole new platform and a whole new way to learn. And we've embraced all of that. And again, it's like, it's enabled us to meet everyone's needs in a way we couldn't possibly do it before.
Absolutely. We're coming to the end of this sort of hour now. We've talked about a, you know, huge range around what the group's doing. Just wanted to touch on some of the highlight. I'm amazed we've made it all this way through, and we're getting a lot of trouble for not doing without mentioning our Ofsted Good this year. So that's we're Ofsted Good across the group, which is a phenomenal achievement for a group this size and the absolute range of stuff we do, to be graded good in absolutely every element of, like, there wasn't one element of what we do that was requires improvement, everything. That is testament to the direction of this group and where it's going. And I think from what's come across clearly from everyone on this call is the care and the passion with which we deal with our students and how we want them to succeed, how we set up the courses for them to succeed. Your results, so let's talk to about those people getting those GCSEs. Good luck tomorrow. Secondly, you'll be absolutely fine no matter what you get. It may be a day of elation. It may feel a bit flat. It may be disappointing. The ultimate thing is it doesn't end there. It's one day, and there's so many options for you, and you can go on to do so much. You can start courses this September with us across the board, doing all sorts of things. If you want to do that, get in touch. If there's adult courses and things that are shorter courses, they run throughout the year. There's come up. We have courses starting every point throughout the year. Apprenticeships start all point through the year. All I'd say is, you could be thinking a New Year's Eve at the end of the year, oh gosh, what am I doing? You know, what do I need to do? I have all these grand plans. Do you know what? Why not get a jump? Why not get a head start on that? So that by the time you get to New Year's Eve, that you've actually spent the last 3 months changing your life and doing something incredible, and you're already way down that journey. I cannot stress that enough. There's so many options out there for you. They're literally in your communities. We've got colleges across the county, across Devon. Well, actually, we've got two in Devon, but we also do the online as well. What I'm going to do is, and thank you, Michaela, thank you for signing in. I'm glad you came and found it helpful. That's really useful. And we look forward to hearing from you tomorrow. It leaves me just really to thank Connor, Debs and Rory for joining us this evening on this call. It's been great to be able to answer some of your questions. We will be using this to share widely as well. Remember that we're a phone call away, we're an email away, and it can be life-changing. Have a lovely, restful evening. Good luck tomorrow if you're getting your results. Good luck to the parents if you've got to get your results. And hopefully we'll see you all on a Cornwall College campus very soon. Thank you, everyone. Goodbye.
Bye.